So everybody voted for something I haven't actually done for a little bit now.
So you're rusty.
Yeah. It's a demo theater.
Woo!
It's the thing where I play a demo disc. The one we're actually going to be playing today, well, we might be playing through part of it because it's actually two discs.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, this is actually number one. I didn't really realize until today that's like, oh, this is the very first demo disc PlayStation Underground put out.
Wait, ever?
I think, I mean, first? It says number one. It's not like volume 10 number one or something. It just says number one on the thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
There are apparently secrets because it's a sticky note in here and somebody wrote some secrets.
Oh, shit.
Enabled? You gotta be kidding. I've
got
nothing but snow here.
Yeah, they make like FMV intros for these discs. They're awesome.
This owns.
Have full control of the tower. The logo was up and looking good, then nothing.
Hey, what's happening back there? We lost the whole transmission.
Hold on, hold on. I'm running
this. This is you trying to get the stream up today, right?
Yeah, this is exactly what it's like with for me getting my stream up. The answer was OBS is a piece of shit. Surprise.
Got it. Tracking is off. I'm gonna realign.
We'll dial it in and let's get back online. We don't want underground members.
Wesker?
Wesker or Master Miller in this foggy steam boiler room.
Oh, it's the Spunkos.
Hang on. We're hanging on dead
it's
air.
Team Spunkos.
Okay, I'm reestablishing the lock. Picture should be clearing up.
Oh, what the fuck? Our game isn't on Xbox Live on the front like they said they would. Microsoft fucked us. God damn it.
Oh, look at this.
So, it's somebody asking for watching Johnny Quest. That actually is really similar to the New Adventures of Johnny Quest. I don't know if you ever saw that cartoon as a kid, but...
Yeah, it was poorly animated.
Yeah, I mean, it was the...
And kind of racist, I think.
No,
right?
I mean... No, that's the old Johnny Quest.
One, yeah.
There was a new one they made in the 90s that was the New Adventures of Johnny Quest that was, like, a new show... That had decent 2D animation, but, like, every episode, they would, for some reason, have to, like, jack into the internet and fight bad guys in cyberspace. And,
Let me check my electronic mail.
When they would jack into the internet, everything was always CG, and it was really terrible. And even as a kid, I was like, I wish they would just be 2D cartoons all the time.
How come they always call it jacking in?
I don't know.
Sounds gross.
I don't think they called it that in the show. I just call it jacking in because that's what they call it in Mega Man Battle Network.
I was going to say, that was like a Mega Man thing, right?
Yeah, Mega Man Battle Network is jack in. I'm going to jack into this teddy bear because it's connected to the internet for some reason.
Isn't that crate from Crash Bandicoot, but it's a little edgier now because there's blood on it?
Yeah. So this is actually a two-disc set. I don't really know what's on either disc.
Is it just me or is it not centered?
The crate?
No, I mean the title, imports, is that not centered in the
I think
middle
the
of the
crate,
screen?
Neither of them look like they're quite centered, no.
Oh my god. That is
scenes,
a weird
download
decision.
Download station, event center, bulletins, get the next transmission, code book. Alright. Let's take a look at all this other goofy shit before we get into these games.
Is that Andross?
It does look like Andross, kind of.
He looks Tech sad. QA. He looks sad like he's a D-lister now and this is all the only work he could get.
Whoa!
Oh shit! Look, there's an arm on that ladder. Oh, there's a titty on that wall. It's got everything a teenage boy needs.
Whoa! It's going to a wireframe. How is a PlayStation character created?
Who thinks up games?
Why are PlayStation CDs black on the bottom?
Who thinks up games? Who do they think they are?
This is your chance. Get technical questions answered. Oh, just send them to us.
Look, this fisheye lens, man.
Oh, it's just like, hey, mail us if you have questions.
We'll put the most interesting questions here, but you can't, because this is a thing that you can't update.
Yeah.
You'd have to get another PlayStation.
I can't wait until next month when they answer why are PlayStation CDs black.
They could have answered that question now, though.
Yeah, they
could. If it's a frequently asked question, they could have answered it now.
Yeah.
And then been like, hey, have more questions?
They could have had a QA guy, like, oh shit. Hey guys, do you want to like...
What inspired Twisted Metal? All of my fantasies.
I saw Bozo the Clown, and then went, what if Bozo the Clown was evil?
Yeah.
And so then I wrote Evil Clown on a whiteboard and circled it 10 times.
And based my entire career off of that whiteboard.
All right, what inspired Twisted Metal?
This man was really inspired, I think, by...
He looks like Rich Evans.
Myself.
He does. He looks like, yeah, Rich Evans with more hair.
Basically inspired by our deep love of action movies.
You know, deep a lot love of inverted colors.
People sort of say, like, we really need another car chase and things like that. And everyone's always bashing on car chases, but we love car chases. And,
what's wrong with car chases? You want to fight about it?
He really does. I am thinking, like... Oh, what's Rich Evans doing? Tell me about Twisted Metal.
It's important to give ourselves the opportunity to actually.
Oh my God!
Actually, be behind the wheel of a car chase like in the
movie. It's David Jobby.
Did you ever play Twisted Metal?
I played one of the demos on a demo disc, actually.
Okay.
I don't know which one it was. It was an early one, though. It was the original PlayStation.
I never got into Twisted Metal.
Yeah, I hated the demo. I was like,
and
what the fuck is this shit?
When I actually played Twisted Metal, like, just a couple of years ago, I was like, oh, I don't like this.
My child self there was
a
new, right.
There was a Twisted Metal for the PS3, did you know that?
Yes, I did, actually.
It was like Twisted Metal was gone for a fair amount of time.
I had that knowledge in the back of my mind.
Several years, and then they were like, hey, what if we brought it back? And then it like kind of flopped, I think.
Yeah. The first one wasn't. The first one was, I think the first one had all the heart that we wanted it to have. I mean, the first one is very much sort of like, we always compare it to sort of like a garage band version of... You know what? Ultimately, the game ended up being, which is Twisted
Mario Kart, but made in a garage band. Also, Evil Clowns.
Evil Clowns.
In terms of presentation, gameplay, things like that. But,
he's so cute. Look at him. He's like a little kid. So young and vital.
I forget the name of the new game he's working on. It's Drawn Something. I keep wanting to say Drawn Together, but that's a cartoon.
Yeah, that's an edgy cartoon, not an edgy game.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like Doodles fighting, but it's kind of ugly.
Yeah, well, they put out new screenshots of that game, and they like massively improved how that game looked, because everything was originally, you know...
Everything was up from where it was, though. I mean, it was ugly.
Yeah, well, I mean, his new game, like, well...
Oh, that was weird.
Well, if they blinked out of existence, that was, for some reason, Elgato losing my signal.
It's just, it's such a richer experience. There's so much more strategy, so much more depth to what you can do.
Strategy, depth, right, Mr. Joffrey, right.
But yeah, the game he's working on, they put out some new screenshots a while ago. Drawn to Death, yeah. Because everything, when they first showed off, everything in that game had like the blue ink pen outline with white notebook texture on it, so everything looked the same. And now they put in some more color and like different tints of like light blues and stuff, so you can like make the characters like
the characters
actually pop out and other important things pop out, so it's just not all blue ink and notebook textures everywhere.
Drawn to Death is not a good title, though. It should have been called like Drawn and Quartered, and you like quarter people to pieces or something.
The biggest leap was just, I mean, I think gameplay says it all. I think it was just a real... Twisted Metal 1 was my second game as a designer. It was.
I feel if anybody made a new Twisted Metal, you know, in that learning style car combat game, nobody would want to play it unless they just made it control... It would have to have a strafing mode like the Batmobile does in Arkham Knight.
Because
nobody wants to turn while you're fighting. Everybody just wants to be able to strafe like it's like you're just a dude and not a car.
Yeah.
What's best about your job?
You know, I really like mapping. I think mapping is just, you know, the key to what it means to be a designer. I mean, I love to sit down at the whiteboard, either with myself or with my fellow designers or fellow development team, and just really sit there with all these markers and figure out what the levels
are. I thought he said napping.
Oh.
That's why I laughed. I thought he said, I love napping.
Look, they wrote Saturn sucks on the whiteboard, and then they had like a stick figure lady with big tits on it.
History of games. I definitely heard napping.
Napping!
And I was like, yeah, it's funny. He's got a sense of humor about himself. I was like, oh no, wait.
Mapping.
Mapping. He likes mapping with an M. Napping is the most fun thing that he does. Napping.
What's your work day like?
I don't really have an average day in the sense that every day I come in and I I shut my door and I design for 2 hours. And then, you know, it's not that structured at all. All of my days are basically centered around making sure that the game that I'm working on at the time
has enough evil clowns in it.
Is all the elements are being poured into it. And some days that'll mean that I'm working on a map all day long for a certain level of the game.
A nap all day long?
Other days that'll mean I'm working with the developers of the game.
Yeah, sometimes I'm only napping for 3 or 4 hours at a time.
Live in the world of the game.
Then I have dreams about clowns, as usual, and then I channel that into my games.
Whoa!
Well, that's nap vision. That's when he just wakes up and it's all blurry.
Yeah. The testers to try to figure out where all the bugs are to make sure.
He won't believe this. I had this dream about an evil clown. Let's put him in the game. Oh wait, we already put one in the game.
Things that I do, but the cool thing about my
what if there was a guy who was stuck between two tires and his name was Axel? That is a real character.
Yeah.
In Twisted Metal.
Alright, so at some
a
point
muscular black man between two big fucking tires.
At some point I'm gonna have to show off. There were for one of the Twisted Metals, they had a because there was a story mode in all the games where it's like you beat it and then the bad guy, I forget his name, like grants your wish, but it's always a monkey's paw thing, so then your character's like, oh.
Sweet Tooth?
No, Sweet Tooth is one of the racers.
He's not. Why is he the mascot if he's not even.
Because he's an evil clown, that's cool.
Alright. Is the bad guy a good clown?
No, the bad guy is just like some guy who's basically Satan, but he's like. He just looks like a businessman.
Hmm.
I forget his name, but he would just like, whoever wins the Twisted Metal competition will get
a wish granted.
Calypso.
Wish.
That's his name, Calypso. But he would grant their wish, but it's always a monkey paws twist thing where it's like, your wish was granted, but now one of them is literally, it's like, your wish was granted, but also I just shot you in the head. Like, there was no ironic twist to this one I saw. It was just like, oh, you got your wish granted? Now you're dead because I shot you in the head.
What? Oh, I saw, you know, world hunger's gone, but cancer got worse.
Yeah.
Or something.
But for one of the Twisted Metals, they actually recorded all those cutscenes as FMV and then decided to cut it, but all of them are on the internet.
Oh, shit.
So at some point, I'll have to show those. Maybe not this stream, but yeah.
I think if you look at the games I've done, if you look at Twisted Metal 1, Twisted Metal 2, the game I'm working on now, you know, it's very apparent what I think about violence in video games. I think I have no problem with it. I mean, I feel it's a way, it's an outlet it's a release, I think, for the things that we have inside. I think it's crazy if someone tells you that, we are not violent creatures, you know? And I would much rather rip someone's head off in a video game and get it out of my system than do it in the real world.
That triangle, circle, triangle, square, I think is a code that you put in somewhere. I think. Let me look at the sticky note.
So the only thing preventing him from killing people in real life is video games. Letting him release that head-tearing off urge in video games. He speaks for us all.
Yeah. What game do you wish you designed?
Super Mario.
There's a game came out a while back called Flashback, which came out for the 16-bit systems, PC, stuff like that. And that was really the first time ever that I had played a game that really immersed me in that world. I mean, for however long it took me to finish that game, I was there, you know, I was in that world. And that, I think, is something that I hope that I can do one day, is really present players with gameplay in worlds that just totally suck them in and make them forget where they are.
Yeah, how's that going 20 years later? So have you done it yet?
People really, to be honest, people really love Twisted Metal, so I think he did.
I don't know about that.
There are adult men who are.
I haven't heard about Twisted Metal fans.
I hear adult people talk very nostalgically about how much Twisted Metal owned. And then they play it and it's like, yeah, look where all the secrets are and all this shit. And you put in the secret code and you shoot an ice missile out of your limo.
But is it like a world? Or is it more like, you know, how the SSX games were like a world you could find secrets in?
Well, the way I...
There's Axel, that's him.
Yeah, there's Axel. He blew up. Rip Axel.
Rip Axel.
Everybody I've heard talk about Twisted Metal just talk about it as in, hey, man, remember this really fun game when we were a kid, the same way people talk finally about, like, GoldenEye.
I'd like to see myself doing comic books one day. I'd love to. I can't draw at all, but I'd love to write comic books.
Aw, that's cute that he's doing a thing about drawing now. That's kind of funny.
Yeah. How do you become a game designer?
there's a couple things I would say.
Download RPG Maker.
It really isn't, at least at this point in time, that hard to get into the industry. You know, at an entry level.
God, think of how easy it is now compared to then, too. With Steam and everything like that.
Yeah.
God. In, you will find a way in. I'm not going to sit here and give you a secret.
Oh!
Ah.
Whoa!
What you want to do, you'll find a way to do it. What I will
Wow, somebody was feeling really creative that day when they put this together.
That was that was in their reel for a while, I bet, that yeah. transition.
So for people watching these videos and like how, you know, thinking like, haha, some nerd had to like edit it together like that and he was like having fun. These types of videos completely falls under what I do at my job.
Yep.
If Volition ever shoots stuff like this, I am the person probably helping shooting it and also editing it.
I hope you do it in this exact same frame rate and bit rate
so
and
that
JPEG compression-y artifact-y
Volition
shit.
Does like to do April Fool's stuff, and I really, I don't...
Get a cute jacket like that.
Oh yeah, totally. I would love to somehow convince some people at Volition, it's like, we need to make videos like this as a joke.
You should, though.
Yeah.
Get kind of viral. Get some personality, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Charisma.
Mm-hmm.
Learn what game making is, make sure you really want to make games, and then just find a way to get in.
Find a way to get in. How do you get in? Find a way to get in.
Oh, so here's a story I read like a week or two ago. There was, I can't remember which game developer studio it was, but some dude just walked into a game dev studio pretending he knew who everybody was and acting like he worked there, and he was able to just sit down, have lunch with people, and have them tell him what the new game they were working on was.
Shit.
Even though they, you know, it's still under embargo and all that stuff. He just walked in there pretending he knew people and had lunch. It's like, well, that's a way to get in, I guess.
Oh my god. It's like yeah. that mission GTA, where you have to infiltrate Life Invader and you dress up like an idiot programmer with khaki pants and the plaid shirt and all that shit.
Yeah.
He's like, no, I work here.
got the uniform on. I never really intended to get into the game business. It was really a total fluke. I had always played games as a kid and stuff, and I'd always been a video game fan, but my initial intention was to go into filmmaking, and I'd gone to film school and all that, and basically the video game thing kind of happened while I had just gotten out of film school, and I was sort of waiting for, you know, the call from Steven Spielberg or Jordan.
Sure.
I kind of vaguely remember this level that's being played in the background. I think this is Twisted Metal. Yeah, this is Twisted Metal 2.
He said he was already talking. He said he was working on it.
Yeah.
So.
Hey. Now that working situation is not what it's like where I work. They
actually have lights in your office.
Well, yeah, there are lights, but I mean, it's also...
yes, there
most,
are lights.
Most people don't work in cubicles. There are no cubicles. Most people work in an open office setting. I'm a person who has my own office, though.
That's pretty swank, dude.
Yeah, I mean, I have to have my own office because it's hard to video edit when everybody else is sitting around you.
Bugging you. So cherubic looking. Look at him.
I wonder how old he was there.
He looks like a baby, like a puppy.
Yeah.
Yep, that's all.
Yep. Oh, apparently select is the back button. Weird.
Bizarre.
Behind the scenes.
Bizarre. Wasn't that kind of behind the scenes? Oh shit, yeah. Where are we going? Oh.
Boom. Are we going to the shark pit again?
I hope so.
Aww. Oh, no. Locker room.
The making of the commercial? Look at that grody banana, that's so 90s.
Yeah.
Oh, can't wait to see the NFL one. That's mm-hmm. when I'm taking my bathroom break.
Oh man, I don't remember this commercial at all.
Style. Sophistication. The ability to launch napalm into oncoming traffic. If these are the things you look for in an automobile, it's time you test drive Twisted Metal 2. Fully automated weaponry, dual rocket launchers, and the new APS flamethrowing system. All standard. Drive the 1997 Twisted Metal 2 on PlayStation from Sony, and let style me your weapon.
That's a charming commercial, I gotta say.
You know what? That's a good commercial.
That's a great commercial.
Show you what it took to make this ad. The Underground has asked me to give you an eyewitness account of the making of the Twisted Metal 2 TV commercial. I'm David Bamberger, product manager for Twisted Metal 2, and I accompany...
I want that for a car, if I ever own a car.
Yeah, that'd be a sweet, great hood ornament.
I want that hood trinket.
Located in the Czech Republic, and has a rich, glamorous feel that we were looking for. We were lucky to find Monique locally. But to get the properly arrogant male lead,
properly
we had to
arrogant.
Import Timothy from England. He actually turned out to be a nice guy.
It was really hard to find an uppity-looking white male.
In the Czech Republic, or wherever they were.
That's pretty fucking sweet, though, they made that car.
Yeah.
Style. Sophistication. The ability to launch napalm into oncoming traffic.
Of course, a missile launcher wasn't a standard feature in these big American cars, so we added one.
I would love to know what the budget was for this commercial.
Yeah.
It seems pretty high budget. I mean, they made that fucking car, and they also had to travel to the Czech Republic for this.
An explosion
happened. We used a real explosion to get the reflection you're about to see in the actor's glasses.
People launch napalm into oncoming traffic.
They framed that explosion in that dude's glasses pretty well.
Yeah, it looks good. They did a good job.
I don't know
job.
About the weird transition there, though.
Yeah.
This next scene was really tough. Our model had a hard time overcoming the urge to run from the gunfire.
Whoa.
Oh my god.
With each blown take, the door had to be rebuilt with fresh explosive caps.
Oh my god!
This is a good video!
This is great!
With only one door panel
she
left,
running like hell, man.
Drive the 1997 Twisted Metal 2 on PlayStation from Sony.
This is one of the last shots we did because the flamethrower actually melted the hood of the car.
Flamethrower melted the car?
Wow.
Holy shit.
And let style be your weapon.
The crew somehow found this big American car in Prague. They worked on it nonstop for a week and turned it into this twisted metal weapon of mass destruction.
Man.
Wow.
It wasn't street legal when we bought it, and it certainly wasn't street legal after. There's your inside look. And remember, drive angry.
That's some guerrilla filmmaking, man.
Yeah, that's pretty great.
Great.
You know, so the primarily one of the big reasons why I miss demo discs, even though they're completely obsolete now because you can just download a demo.
Mm.
And also demos are obsolete because everybody just makes it early access or a beta and then you charge money for it anyways.
Yeah.
I miss demo discs because it was a package of content. It wasn't something. It wasn't like the sprinkled shit that you did. Like every day, you check the internet, and there's something there.
Mm, it was. It was.
It was like
chunk.
You waited for a month. You got a thing, and it was just this big digest of stuff. You got all at once, and I feel it was more fun looking forward to something rather than just getting shit all the time. Going like, yeah, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
They upload to YouTube.
Mm-hmm. You don't really cherish something like that.
Yeah,
and it's also like these are physical copies of something.
Yeah.
Old-timey mocap.
Tim Brown came into our motion capture studio, and the result, you can see
Whaley.
In the smoothest animation in football.
He's a whale of a man.
People in the chat going, we imported football men from the stadium. Oh, do I recognize any of these football men? Well, wait, it's NFL. No, I'm not going to recognize them. For some reason, I only recognize college football players.
Cause that's what my
That's what my dad watched. He was way more into college. He's way more into college football still
for each frame,
in the NFL.
It will go through and it will figure out where each
so unless it's somebody who came from, well,
dots actually
those football players come from college.
What's the difference
really don't mean anything, please,
between college and NFL?
College and NFL, I mean...
Like, one is bigger than the other, but like, what is the...
College football
what
is...
What is the taste difference for your dad, voila, do you think?
Oh, so, you know, I don't
like,
know.
What appeals to him that in right college so football that doesn't appeal to him so from NFL?
You know, I'm not really sure. I don't... That's a question I should ask my dad someday. I've never asked him.
Get him on the stream.
Yeah, I've never asked him why he's more into college than NFL's more professional, I guess. Like I there's kind of people who are into college football, they are more interested in seeing like the players develop, because it's like every year there's like a draft where it's like, okay, all these college kids are going to get drafted into the NFL. So then there's this whole thing where you're following all these people going like, oh man, I wonder who's going to bid for what. Who's
going to, like, if you like those people, why wouldn't you follow them to the NFL and then be interested in what teams pick them up or whatever.
Yeah. There is some, for college football, there's also like a more, you know how everybody has like school spirit and shit? I think a lot of people get attached to that and like to stick with that even after they're out of school.
Yeah.
And like you can still have that just by going like, ooh, I'm rooting for the, you know, whatever
the college team. Or
yeah.
Whatever. Somebody.
It can feel more local.
Bodhi Chan said, the college men just have younger, tighter rumps. It's more appealing.
That's true.
That's probably why your dad's watching it.
Damn, no.
Well, I think they got tighter rumps.
Download station.
I think your dad sounds like Plinkett for some reason.
I don't think my dad really sounds
like Plinkett
that much. He doesn't.
I only heard him in like that one No More Heroes video like years ago or whatever it was.
He was in No More Heroes. He appeared briefly in Metal Gear Solid 2. And he also appeared briefly in Lego Star Wars, but I think he was cut because he talked for a very long time.
Aww.
And it was about serious stuff.
He's overdue for another appearance.
It's true. Carnage Heart is one of the most in-depth strategy games ever created.
Carnage Heart took
Japan by storm a year ago and has just been unleashed in the U.S. by Sony Computer Entertainment America in Art Dink. Oh, I bet they're not around
Art
anymore.
Art Dink, oh.
The object is to design... Well, all right, I didn't press any buttons, but...
It thought that was long enough for you to
read about
the
designers and OKEs. Whoa, look at this.
Uh-huh.
He has a strength stat.
He, the creator, has a strength stat?
Oh, they have... Okay. Hot Fist is a fighting OKE. Brutal vehicle unit.
What?
Oh my god.
The sidestep stepper. This one's called the toe tapper.
Juju Man 02. Body type. Cougar.
Hug 9090. Aww. Hug 9090 Mark II. It's a better, more advanced hug. Death Spheres. What?
Oh, my memory card's full. Damn it. Wait, can I swap memory cards?
It doesn't recognize because this is PlayStation 1. Yeah. You're playing it on whatever.
Well, I mean, it emulates.
Probably.
No, this is PS3. PS4 can't do PS1 games. Whatever. The PS3 emulates PS1 memory cards, though. But
how does it download?
It's probably just on the disc, it saves it to your memory card.
It's on the disc, but it's like they couldn't.
Yeah,
just let you play it.
America's largest trade show.
E3.
Oh,
get excited for E3.
You might have read about it in gaming magazines and maybe even seen a few pictures. But now, through the use of time-lapse photography, The Underground takes you for a quick look inside E3, making of Sony's outrageous booth from the ground up.
Let's see how baby E3. Well, it's still a fairly big conference hall, but it's still pretty baby compared to what it is now.
Yeah. You know, I never think, like, how much effort is it to really set up a convention center?
It's
pretty impressive when you think about it.
Yeah, it's... E3 now is, like, they start setting up a couple weeks beforehand, just getting all the shit up.
Yeah.
And that's not counting, like, people coming in and setting up the booths. This is just, like, setting the groundwork.
Yeah, all the lights.
So imagine the cabling nightmare E3 is.
Oh, my God. I would not want to be in charge
of that. I think my apartment is a cabling nightmare. Like... This is a pretty awesome soundtrack they've got, though.
Yeah.
So I was looking through music libraries, and I found a big collection of old 90s stock music. Not music made to sound like it, but music made in the 90s for business-like videos and stuff.
Interesting. Where'd you find this?
I forget what it's called. I have it bookmarked somewhere. It's just like one of the more professional, like, businessy. Oh, crash!
Look at him!
Oh, my God. Ah. There's a boulder behind him.
Oh,
it is one of the stock music places that like a lot of larger businesses use.
Huh.
This is almost the Hey Arnold theme song.
It's close, yeah.
I'm gonna have to go find it because, wow, I want to get that music to use it in videos myself. Mm-hmm. But the amount of money you need to pay for it is kind of a lot.
Is that a UFC cage? Have nerds fight to the death in it. Spyro versus Crash.
There's some good bass slaps happening.
Seinfeld-esque.
Yeah.
Ding, ding, ding.
Oh.
Oh my god, arcade cabinets.
You know, after messing around with the MAME machine at work a whole bunch, I really want to make my own arcade MAME cabinet thing. It's not even that hard to do, really.
I don't think I've ever played on a MAME cabinet.
MAME cabinets are fucking cool. Like, it wouldn't even be that expensive, either, to make, basic MAME cabinet.
If you got the money and the know-how, I mean, go for it.
Yeah, you don't even need to have, a powerful computer, because all the games you're emulating are,
Yeah, that's true. Oh my god,
was that Bubsy? That was fucking Bubsy! At some point, somebody made a MAME-sized Bubsy costume?
That is rotting in a warehouse somewhere. Right
now. Oh, that's...
Oh my god.
That's a collector's item.
I can't wait for the chat to react to Bubsy. I'm gonna watch. We're gonna be like, oh my god, Bubsy!
Does the cabinet have Ninja Baseball Batman? It does. It has every single game on there, basically.
Oh my god, Bubsy. Ah. Bubsy! There they go.
I'm glad the delay seems to be much better than last week.
Yeah, last week was, stupid.
That might have been due to the video buffer being really high and I forgot to reset it. Oops. I was using OBS to record.
Oh, look at all this.
Too extreme! It said too extreme with the number 2!
Oh shit, what the fuck is that?
Oh, it's ejecting a giant CD!
Oh, that's so cool! Fuck! Dude.
Too extreme.
Dude, that's radical.
Oh, Toe Ball number 1.
That it's
Jet Moto.
Injecting
the CD. I played the Jet Moto demo a lot as a kid. There was a lot of Mountain Dew advertisements in it.
Crash Bandicoot!
What if I should go get a Mountain Dew right now to get more into the zone? I do have some Mountain Dew. My dad gave me a bunch when I visited him for July 4th.
Well, he knows you're a gamer. You need gamer fuel.
It's true. Thanks, Dad.
Crash Bandicoot! So radical!
Have you ever thought that... Size of football field.
Oh,
okay,
a single football field.
That's pretty small.
Oh, that's so quaint.
It looks pretty banging, though. Look at all these fucking lights. It's awesome. Ow. I just wrapped my knuckle on my coffee table.
Yikes. Satellite dish on the roof! Oh, yes! We have a satellite dish on the roof!
Damn.
No, they letterboxed that.
That was also a great video.
That was great. I loved it. Oh, I thought the back of that bulletin board was the bulletin, so I was that's boring. Like some Silent Hill ass looking rusty bulletin board.
Have you ever had the thought that I wish I could go back in time and do something cool for my kid self? Like, not do something cool as a kid, but go back in time, see yourself as a kid, and do something cool for them?
To yourself?
I would take myself to E3 when I'm when I'm 10 years old, because I didn't know what E3 was yet. I think
I love this fan fiction of yourself.
Right? I would go visit myself and would you I'd also buy myself Mega Man 7 because that's something I saved up money for to buy and then I couldn't find it anywhere.
I would have bought myself a Nintendo 64 when it came out because I didn't get it until the end of its life.
Aww.
And I was pissed.
Dang.
My parents didn't want me to play that many video games because I thought it was unhealthy that I was inside all the time. But when I was outside, I was injuring myself because I was a fucking clumsy little idiot. I was bleeding every time I came inside because I would fall. If I was on a bike, I would fall. If I was on rollerblades, I would fall.
Yeah.
And it's you should keep me inside playing video games. I'm gonna friggin' kill myself out here.
Look at that. Look in the upper left. Look at that dog. It looks like that one stupid creepy dog image somebody made, where they combine the dog's face with meat.
Yeah.
Black market stuff. Cool things to wear and use that carry the PlayStation Underground logo, a signal to other gamers that you have access to inside information available nowhere else.
As if you're a drug dealer or something.
Details next issue.
He dresses like a gamer.
Whoops. Not mean
so
to back
would,
out.
So would you tell your child self that it was you, your future self, or would that mess up the space-time continuum at all?
I haven't thought that part through.
Because that part's important.
How do you convince your past dad to let you take you to E3?
Yeah, that's true. This plan isn't well thought out. I just want it to happen.
Look at this Comic Sans situation.
You think you have talent?
No.
When you were a kid, did you ever get game magazines?
No. I didn't even get fucking Nickelodeon magazine.
God damn.
I wanted Nickelodeon magazine so
bad. Dude, okay, so I really want Nick magazine too.
And my parents were like, no.
I never got Nickelodeon magazine, but it was just because I never had enough like initiative to like ask for it, because I already had other magazine subscriptions, so I didn't want to bother my mom.
People are probably thinking my parents were not very supportive of me growing up. Like, my parents are terrible. My parents are awesome. They just didn't want me to have superfluous shit.
Yeah.
It's things they thought was a waste of money. They thought Nickelodeon magazine and game magazine is a waste of money. If I knew about game magazines, I would have gotten them. I didn't really know about them. I was playing I was playing things that were too old for me. Like, I was playing the ColecoVision until I was like six, mm-hmm. practically. Five or six. And then we got a Sega Genesis.
Yeah.
And then we stuck with the Sega Genesis. Didn't get a SNES or an NES.
Mm-hmm.
Went from ColecoVision to Genesis.
Oh, man.
To N64 when it was practically dead. And PlayStation 1 around the same time. But we only got a PlayStation 1 because there was educational software on that people at my brother's school were trying on him because he's mentally disabled.
Mm.
So they were like, oh, it's like a learning tool thing.
Okay.
And I usurped that PlayStation 1.
Oh,
I was playing this horrible educational game because it was the only new game we had in the house. I was tired of playing Sonic 1 or whatever it was. And it was like about a blue moose in France at the Tour de France. I have no idea what this game was. Somebody in the chat better know what this horrible piece of shit game was, but I played the fuck out of it because it's the only thing we had. And then eventually, I think me being obsessed with it was like, maybe we should get our kid this thing and buy other games for it and stuff.
Yeah. Somebody earlier in the chat asked, would I tell kid myself about 9/11?
Oh my god! What kind of question is that?
Would I warn him about it?
Oh my god, no!
Kid myself would not have the power to stop it from happening.
What in the world?
If my child self somehow had the power to stop 9/11, I would tell him, yes.
But he definitely doesn't have the power. How old were you, like 11?
When 9/11 happened?
Yeah.
I was 12, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a 12-year-old that doesn't need to know that shit's gonna happen.
I was in fucking...
Holy God.
I was in fucking algebra class when that happened.
Jesus Christ.
Anyways, what I was gonna say before all this happened.
What a derail.
I was subscribed to Nintendo Power until... Like, I was subscribed until they quit making magazines.
Uh-huh.
But just seeing that fan art on the side, I sent in fan art multiple times.
Aww.
I don't think it ever got shown, but they sent this adorable letter I wish I still had, which was, if your fan art does not get chosen to be shown in the next issue of Nintendo Power, they say, thank you for the mail, the fan art, and then they give you a picture where they show where they put up your fan art in somebody's office.
Aww,
everybody,
that's so sweet.
Everybody got kids' fan art, and they all, everybody had it pinned up in their offices if it didn't get used in a magazine.
That's so cute.
Yeah, what is this? Just question mark. Tell us what's cool and what sucks about this first transmission. You can
grab
also
a video caddy and record the comments and then send them the VHS or something.
Yeah, you can also record yourself showing off with your PlayStation or make any sort of offbeat video about it. We might include portions of your video in a future issue. Oh shit, I hope.
Oh wow.
What is this Godzilla on the left there?
And not the entire URL to send it to, or email address rather.
Subscribe. Well, hottest demos, codes, interviews, and tips.
Yeah,
oh, remember, music.
Remember when subscribe wasn't just a YouTube thing?
Oh, yeah. Somewhere on the second CD you receive are music videos from two hot bands!
Oh.
Yes! 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 I'm like fist pumping right now. Yes! Yes!
Yes!
It's been,
you'll get a copyright claim on it.
I don't care. I'll just upload it to Balderdash or something. So, this is my favorite thing about demo disc is going and seeing really stupid-ass music videos. Okay, that's just fine print shit. Copyright 1996.
Fine print.
Get the next transmission.
Copyright.
So, you want developers? Demos of the hottest new games?
codes, yeah. tips, and tricks you can't get anywhere else?
Yes.
Cool black market underground gear.
Not your head.
Black market.
Yes.
To get all that 4 times a year, you gotta subscribe to the Underground Magazine. And to subscribe, you gotta have a plan.
Here's the plan.
Get up off the couch. Step over the coffee table. No, no, don't look away. Walk through the dirty laundry. It is critical.
What if I don't have an apartment because I'm 9?
With anyone, or they will try to make you pick things up.
God, exposed brick. Very classy.
Yeah, this is a David Cage studio apartment.
You're at the door. Think back to when you picked up the mail. You saw the underground CD, so you threw the rest of the mail aside.
Concentrate!
You ripped open the expensive, well-planned mailer.
Why is Satan helping me do this? All
design hours, video games are the devil.
Just tossed it, only to grab out the CD.
That rug really ties the room together, though.
Subscription card is in the front cover.
Where did you throw it?
On the floor? In the trash? Crushed in the doorway? Find it. And the cool stuff, the games, the codes.
The power!
I can get yours. A denim jacket!
Find the subscription card.
Or Jet Moto.
Get out! Don't screw up. This is a great plan. In fact, subscribe.
A hi-fi stereo.
Oh shit, you can get the jacket that David Jaffe was wearing, I think.
Oh fuck.
Upload in your CD case for details.
4 external speakers and more.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Wow. So.
So cool.
Something that was in gaming magazines and like electronic related, like.
Oh man, there's lightning in the background. I just noticed
yeah,
that.
Yeah, and like computer magazines.
And the
magazines.
Walls are made of dice.
Yeah. And like computer magazines and shit, and it still happens today. I still see it. There's always an advertisement where you just send in your name, basically, and like mail it to them. And you could get a chance to win like the ultimate gaming setup, which is like a giant TV, a surround sound system, and like all the hottest game systems and a bunch of games and all this other crazy shit, like gaming chair and a couch. That advertisement has had various forms since like the early 90s in magazines. Mm-hmm. And it's still in magazines today, and apparently there's an article somewhere out there about that stuff, and it's the same company that does all of them. And it basically nobody has ever won one, apparently.
Really?
Or like one guy has won one or something. And it's basically just a way to like scam people out of money.
Oh my god, what the fuck? I remember seeing like Nickelodeon kids shows, like Double Dare and Legends of the Hidden Temple, and the grand prize was always like a trip to a dude ranch.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't want to go to a dude ranch. Dude ranch. Psych. Yo, how immature.
Wow. We were going to print some of the hidden codes and hints for Jet Moto, Twisted Metal 2, Cool Borders, and NFL Game Day 97 on this page. But after thinking about it, how exclusive would these codes be? And the first Underground members posted them on the net immediately after finding them. So we thought we'd make it a little more sporting. Therefore,
so people will have to look it up on the internet.
Yeah, yeah. Therefore, hidden in different spots in this magazine are codes and hints from the games listed before, and hitting the right button combination in the correct area brings them up.
Oh,
so like
God.
That fine print that David Jaffe video said like triangle, circle, square, triangle, something. I bet that's one of them. If you are a code demon.
But this isn't a magazine.
If you're a code demon, you should be able to find them all. But don't worry if you can't. We'll print their location in the next issue, so you won't have to ask your friends for help.
So they're calling this a magazine?
Oh, no, I think... No, you're right. The stuff was actually hidden in the actual magazine.
That came with this?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Whoa, look at this code archive.
Your UK female commentators?
You can switch over to female commentators for Adidas PS. Power Soccer.
Oh my god, SJW's ruining soccer games, putting women in it. Ugh.
Assault Rigs, god. Bogey Dead 6, what the fuck are these games?
What the hell's Bogey Dead?
Destruction Derby.
Bogey Dead?
ESPN Extreme Games.
What kind of game is Bogey Dead 6? Can you tell by the context?
Let's see. Infinity Code, to earn an unlimited amount of aircraft.
It's a flying game. Okay, Bogey Dead, the flying game.
You will now see a pile of gold bars. Get a missile lock and destroy the gold! There is no need to finish the training unless you're really into it.
Game Breaker.
Game Day. Jumping Flash. Jumping Flash 2.
God. Lemmings 3D.
King of Fighters. Hey, Lemmings 3D. Look at all these level codes.
Oh, wow. That's a lot of levels.
If I ever somehow end up like... Oh man, there's even more.
Oh my god.
Mortal Kombat 3. Motor 2, NBA Shootout, Nova Storm.
There's Twisted Metal.
Yeah, Samurai Showdown, Total Number 1. Battle Arena Toshinden, not a good game.
Hmm.
If I ever somehow end up making a game and I'm not just like the video editor, but I actually like work, like actually designing a game or something, I am totally putting in fucking cheat codes and nobody can stop me.
Nobody.
I'll make that game 90s as fuck.
They'll try to hold you back, say, Chip, no, don't.
I'm putting in all the cheat codes.
Be like, fuck you,
Big
haters.
Head mode, fuck you, it's going in.
Weren't there, like, cheats in Contradiction and we couldn't figure out what it was?
Yeah, there's a cheat system in Contradiction, but, like, I beat it yesterday and it's like, congrats, you did it with no cheats. And I was like, but...
How do you use cheats? What are the cheats?
Yeah.
Is there a big head mode?
Like, I used the hint system, but that wasn't the cheats.
The tip system, yeah. You kind of have to use the tip system.
Yeah, there are times where it's just like, oh, this is the time I actually need to run through the forest and not just teleport through it. Look, that CD's on fire.
Oh,
why would you do that to your games, bro?
Radical. Anarchy. The 90s.
These are all demos of games I don't want to play.
Yeah, none of these are good.
Well, some of them might
not
be good, but
they're
definitely things that are not up my alley.
Yeah, that's what I mean when I say shit like that, generally speaking.
Yeah, people, yeah.
People take it too literally.
Cycle
I just
through.
Mean I don't like it.
Cycle through VR modes.
If you press a circle, you can eat a grapple, which is a grape apple.
Mmm.
That's a real thing that someone engineered. An
wow.
apple that tastes like a grape.
Holy shit, I want to try that.
And not just like a grape, like the artificial grape flavor.
Oh shit, now I really want to try
it. They call them fucking grapples.
Dude.
They might have them where you're at. I've seen them in just like regular grocery stores. It's like, hey, they're grapples.
Oh man. Mountain Dew, yeah!
Wow.
Look at this art for Dakota.
Oh my goodness. That's some great like 90s comic book art.
Wild ride. Is this all ladies? It's all ladies.
Oh my god.
Wait.
All titty havers.
Oh, it's the racers and dudes. No.
The ex-wife, Blackjack. Bulakajak.
I don't remember this part of Jet Mode. There are dude racers too, right?
Maybe this is just like, hey, look, there's sexy ladies all the time. Hey, boys, buy this game with the ladies.
Yeah.
Even though you can't tell they're women at all by their models. They just look like Mountain Dew sponsored.
I love that you can only play as the Mountain Dew. Oh, wait, here we go. Oh, okay, wait. It's just divided by gender then.
Oh, I see. And Mountain Dew is for women, I guess. And whatever this is for men. Well, that's a lady.
Oh, there's another lady. Quick Jesse.
Quick Jesse.
And Paris. Huh.
Huh.
There's some awesome interlacing happening when these guys spin around.
Yeah, it's pretty hideous.
Mountain Dew.
Those are only teams. Mountain Dew and whatever that was.
Yeah, you can only play as this one person.
Was that some other kind of soda? K2?
K2?
Whatever
I don't know.
It was? Damn.
Oh, this hurts to look at.
Crunch bars, yeah. Look at all this advertising. Baby
Ruth.
Oh my god. Well, you can fall off. I didn't know you could actually fall off these things.
The frame rate's decent.
Yeah,
but
actually.
Oh,
but wait.
Butterfinger! I'm gonna be really bad at this because I'm having a hard time
Why
making out.
Why are they coming out of that thing? You were in that thing.
I don't know,
it's
but
telling
I just
you
got,
to go there.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a loop-de-loop.
I am going to be terrible at all these demos, just as a forewarning.
This is like the Duck Dynasty races.
Nah, this is better than Duck Dynasty.
You're in a swamp, but you're racing.
That part is correct.
Product placement.
Yeah.
Come on, John Luke. Oh my god, this is so silly.
Yeah. Ramp it.
Can you imagine if real races happened like this?
This is
like,
this
so incredibly amazingly dangerous.
Yeah, it would be way cooler though. This game's real hard for me to look at.
Yeah, like, this is hideous.
I am used to like
everything
the chunky pixely PlayStation look and I actually kind of like it.
But there's
this
something
game,
to do with the colors that make it worse because they're all equally saturated, so your brain can't process what you're really supposed to be looking at.
This game's real hard for me to...
Because everything's equally as important looking saturation-wise.
Yeah.
It's garish.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I can even, like, play games like Wild Arms 2 fine, and that game has, like, a really poor font choice for it being a PlayStation game.
I also feel like the speed at which you're going past these hideous textures is making it a lot more visually clusterfucking.
Yeah. I mean, this game, I remember playing this demo as a kid and being a little more into it. This seems like a decent racing game if, you know, your eyes cooperate with it. Which mine are not.
Getting nauseous.
At least the frame rate isn't super shitty. That would make this way worse.
Yeah, that would make it awful.
At this point, if the frame rate was really bad, it would be completely, like, unplayable.
God, that grass that's alternating pixels of green, at, like, bright green and black. Oof.
Yeah. Oof. Oh, God!
Music's okay.
Yeah.
What? What was that?
Grapple. You can grapple to objects and it pulls you towards them, apparently.
Whoa.
So you can do, like, really sharp turns by, like, grappling onto it like Batman does in the Tim Burton movie. Remember that?
20th place!
Remember when he shoots the grappling hook out of the tire of the Batmobile and he does it to do...
I gotta rewatch the...
Gut-wrenching 3D tracks, no shit!
Yeah, more like eye-wrenching. Wrenching my eyes out of my skull. Bone-crushing, gut-wrenching... What other... colorful combos do we have here?
200 foot drops.
Stomach it. Stomach those drops. Eat them.
Loading.
I don't know about you, but I could go for a Nestle's Crunch Bar right about now.
You know, I could honestly probably eat a shit ton of candy right now. You ever eat so much candy as a kid that you, like, got really sick?
Oh yeah.
I got close.
I threw the fuck up, man. I ate an entire bag of mini Reese's Cups.
Oh, boy.
Because they were on sale because it was after Halloween. So I bought one of those when I was like 8, maybe, something like that. Mm-hmm. And I ate the whole goddamn thing. And I threw up so much peanut butter and chocolate.
Oh, boy.
I was throwing up so much.
I don't think I've ever...
candy.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever thrown up by eating so much candy, but there...
And to this day, I can't eat them because I feel
gross.
Oh, no! Yeah, because I threw them up, and now I associate them with getting
that
sick.
That sucks. Yeah. I love peanut butter cups. More... Less Reese's and more, like, ones, like, an old lady baked.
I don't mind the Reese's Pieces.
Reese's Pieces are good.
They're different for some reason, but the peanut butter cups...
There's less peanut butter in them.
They gross me out now. Because of what happened. The incident.
Roadkill. Twister. Axel.
That's there. He is. It's Axel.
Hi.
Oh my god, look
I'm
at him.
I'm fucking dumb
as
shit.
He's a 2D sprite.
Yeah,
I never noticed that.
Axel himself is just a sprite.
Oh my god. I never noticed he's a fucking 2D sprite. And I played as Axel because he was the most ridiculous looking one.
He has missile launchers on his goddamn shoulders.
He's got missiles on his shoulders.
Look at the art of him. He looks all badass and shit, but it's like, no.
And he's just wearing blue jeans. That's Mr. Slam to you.
Mr. Slam. I like that the thing has teeth, though.
Please, Mr. Slam is my father.
Shadow. Hammerhead. Outlaw 2.
Does Shadow spin around? Is this roundabout?
No.
You should play that and plug that roundabout is going to...
Mr. Grimm.
...to be on Summer Games Stunquick.
Thumper. Spectre.
Spinner.
Wow, no Sweet Tooth.
No, I think you have to unlock him later on in the game.
Okay, what's the coolest car here?
In the non-demo, but I'm not sure.
It's probably Roadkill because it's red.
Aw. You're not going to go with Axel, the most absurd thing I've ever seen? His name
maybe,
is Axel, and
maybe,
he's between two
maybe
wheels?
Maybe I'll go back.
Shit,
if I'm not feeling this dude. Up on the D-pad is accelerate. Oh, wait, so is square. Okay, good.
That's good.
Another PlayStation game with, like, a decent frame rate, so...
Yeah, this is the demo that I played all those years ago when I decided Twisted Metal is for suckers. Oh, there's Sweet Tooth. Strafing would definitely make this easier.
Mm-hmm.
You have zero lives. What a short demo.
Yeah.
Person?
Yeah. You can run over.
That's how I want to go.
It's Yeah, you were talking earlier about how dying by exploding would be a decent way to go.
But I mean very thoroughly exploding.
Very thoroughly
exploding. Not like an explosion went off near me. That would be terrible.
Yeah. I need a health pickup.
I mean like someone just throws a grenade at me, and it, as soon as it hits my body,
you blew
before
up.
I even notice.
Whoa!
You just meet.
Yeah. I love that sound effect, though, when you pick shit up.
Weep.
That's a Hanna-Barbera sound effect.
You know it is, actually.
A lot of sound effects from Hanna-Barbera's cartoons are really stuck in my mind just because I saw the cartoon so much as a kid, because, you know, during the summer, a lot of times in the afternoon, it's like, there's nothing on. And it's like, mm-hmm. So you go to Cartoon Network,
and you
it would
get
be,
desperate.
It would
watch
be.
These old things.
Yeah, I would get desperate because it's like, I want to watch Two Stupid Dogs, but it's not there. So.
Oh, I know about watching things out of desperation. I used to watch Zoom.
What's Zoom?
Exactly.
What is Zoom?
It's a fucking PBS kids show where they did like science experiments and they made a.
Oh, I blew up!
A BW language. And they danced and stuff. It was a slight budget difference away from being public access TV. It had a better budget than public access TV. It was boring.
Yeah.
And bad. And it was me wishing that Bill Nye was on or Miss Frizzle or something.
There is a sound effect from Hanna-Barbera stuff that is so stuck in my head, and it's a really funny sound effect. And it's the sound effect they would use for when pterodactyls would make sounds. They go, ah! They had this specific thing. They use it all the fucking time. Anytime they had a monster that flew, they would always use this ah sound.
Ah.
NFL Game Day 97. I can't believe I have to play a fucking football game.
You have to for thoroughness.
Thoroughness. I won't play all demos all the way through if they're long or if it's fucking bullshit or if I hate the game.
Well, I'm going to use this opportunity to use the bathroom because this is going to be boring as shit.
Football... If this were like NFL Blitz or something, I'd be more into it because you could like do crazy shit. Oh, do I want to be the Packers or the Patriots? I'll be the Patriots because I think some football man from the team my dad likes got drafted to them. Also, I just suddenly got extremely hungry. Oh, God. But I want to play more demos. Okay, let's see how long I can sustain a football game for, because it's probably going to be like 10 seconds max before I go, fuck this. Those are very cute sprites, though. Oh my god. Pets. I'm going to receive. Oh shit! They got... Nice. I wonder how much licensed music's actually in here. I thought it said Gremlin. I kind of wish this game was more like Tech Mobile, because there was a really easy way to fake out the AI and get touchdowns every single time you got the ball.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh boy, it's only starting.
Hey, football!
It's only starting.
Hike, Megat.
Megat.
Those circles should go over there, but not over there.
What the fuck?
It's you're picking up the
Rolleberg. Rolleberg.
Blue 32, blue 33, 34. Hi.
Just do this until the time runs
32,
out.
32, blue 33, hut 32. Hi, go. Get it, go. Yeah. First down, I think.
Oh my god, what is sports?